Hey everybody, let's build an HDRI library in Blender's Asset Browser together for free. The Blender Asset Browser can be used for a lot of things. Today we're using it to build an HDRI library. HDRIs are high dynamic range images used to create world lighting in our scenes. If you need an introduction to HDRIs, I've got an intro video you can check out first. By the end of this video, we'll have a library of free HDRIs inside of our asset browser. With this library, we can browse HDRIs and easily drag them into our scene. Every Blender user should take the time to set one of these up. Let's go. I should mention that I'm using Blender 3.2 for this. The asset library was added in Blender 3.0, but I'm not sure worlds were supported in that version. This definitely works in Blender 3.2 and beyond. The very first thing we need to do is download several HDRIs. If you already have a bunch of HDRIs, then you can skip past this part. Let's start at polyhaven.com, formerly HDRI Haven. Click Browse HDRIs, and here we have a ton of free HDRIs we can choose from to build our library. Let's download a few with different lighting conditions. Let's make sure to get some clear daylight ones, some cloudy ones, some starry night sky ones. Oh, and this sunset one looks pretty. We can choose interior HDRIs as well, really anything we are going to want inside of our asset browser library. When we download these, we have different options up here. I'm choosing 8K EXR files, but if you're tight on space, you can choose to download them in 4K. Now you probably have some form of organization for how you manage your 3D assets. I have a Blender folder, and in that folder, I have an HDRI folder. Wherever you choose to store your HDRIs is fine, but you should have one central place for them. Now we need to create a new Blender file and store it somewhere that makes sense. You'll see why in a minute, but I'm going to store it right here in my HDRI folder. So we will open up Blender and immediately save the new file in the location we've chosen on our computer. This file is going to serve as the current file, or in other words, the home base file for all of the HDRIs in our library. I will name mine HDRI Library. Now it doesn't matter what else is in the scene, so let's just delete all of this. Before we do anything in here, we have to set up a file path to our library so the Blender Asset Browser will know where to find all of our HDRIs. We'll go into Edit, Preferences. Down toward the bottom, we have a tab for File Paths. And at the bottom of this, we have Asset Libraries. I already have some asset libraries set up. You may only see the default one, but let's set up a specific library just for our HDRIs. Click the plus icon to add a new library. Now we want to navigate to the location where we saved this new blend file that is going to be our home base or current file for the library. This is the file we are in right now, which I named HDRI Library. This is not necessarily where we saved the actual HDRIs, just in case you saved them in a different place. The location of the Blender file is what's important for this. So we've got the name of our library, HDRIs, and the file path to that home base file right here. Save the preferences and close out of here. We are going to create a different world for each HDRI. We do that by going to the World Properties tab in the Properties panel. The world is basically the sky and the infinitely far away globe that surrounds our entire scene. Worlds can serve as a background for our scene and can also provide light for our scene. We already have a default world called World. In Render Preview mode, we can see the world. I'll change the color here just so you can see what the world actually is. We'll keep this world and bring in our first HDRI. Let's go to the shading workspace and in the shader editor, change this drop-down box from object to world. This lets us use nodes to edit the world instead of the object materials. If this use nodes box is not checked, you'll need to turn that on. I'll also go into render preview mode up here so we can see the world in this workspace as well. This is the basic world setup with a simple background color fed into a world output node. We'll leave this but press Shift A to add a new node. Search for an environment texture node. Plug the color of the environment into the color of the background. The world turns purple because we don't have an image selected over here. Let's click Open and navigate to the folder where we stored all of our HDRI files. Hopefully you saved them all in one place. Select the first HDRI we want to add to the library. Now back to the world property settings. The default name of world isn't going to work for us. Let's give this world a name which describes the HDRI that we've added. I'll call this one Sunny Day 1. Next, we need to mark this world as an asset. To do this, we right-click on the name of the world and then choose Mark as Asset. This just told Blender that we want this world to be available in our asset browser. We can test to see if this worked by changing the editor window from the shader editor to the asset browser editor. The asset browser is accessed right here with the icon that looks like books sitting on a shelf. So in our current file, we have one asset and it's the sunny day one we just added. It created a pretty terrible preview image. I will show you how to change that in just a few. By the way, current file is the default here, and it only shows what is saved in this actual file. The drop-down box will display any libraries we have set up, including our HDRI library. If we select that, we see the HDRI is in that library as well, and that is good. We've got more to cover, but if you've made it this far, I would love it if you gave the video a like really quick. It's hugely appreciated. Thank you. Now let's go back to the shader editor and add some more HDRIs to our library. This next step is very important. If we just changed our HDRI image here, we'd only be updating our single HDRI in the library and not actually adding a new one. So go back up to the name of the HDRI, and the middle icon on the right is for creating a new world. Press that, and now it's created sunnyday1.001, which is an exact duplicate of the first sunny day world. Clicking the drop-down box will show that we have two worlds available in this blend file. And this F next to the first one is good because it indicates the world has been automatically saved as a fake user. But that is not really anything we need to cover right here. Anyway, now with this new world selected, we can go to our environment node and click the file folder button. It opens right up to where our HDRIs are stored, and we can choose a new HDRI to add. This time I'll choose a cloudy one, open image. Just like before, we will give this one a new name, such as Cloudy Sky 1. Then we'll right-click it and select Mark as Asset. Then we'll click the New World icon again, and it creates our third world. Back to the Environment node. Click the folder icon and find our next HDRI to add. Select it and press Open Image. Change the name, right-click, and Mark as Asset again. We should have three HDRIs in our library now. You probably want to add lots and lots more, and I encourage you to. But in the interest of time, we are just doing three here. Let's go back to the asset browser and see. Yep, three assets, but the preview images are useless. Let's fix those now. Select the first one we made, the sunny day world. Press N on the keyboard, and the sidebar opens on the right in the asset browser. Right here, we have an area to customize the preview image of the asset. We can click the file folder icon and navigate to our HDRI folder. Make sure you choose the correct HDR image for this world. They need to match. Then just click on it and press Load Custom Preview. Now, that's an 8K image, obviously huge for a thumbnail, but since it doesn't seem to slow anything down, Blender must be shrinking it down to optimize as a thumbnail. I'm not really sure though. Anyway, we can do this for the other worlds while we are still here in this file. Make sure we save the file, that is super important. Before we get to the best part, which is actually using this library, there's one more step we may want to consider to keep our library organized. On the left of the asset browser, we have this area which displays what are called catalogs. Catalogs serve kind of like folders, although they're really more like filters for our assets. If we want to categorize our HDRIs, say we want a catalog of daytime HDRIs, indoor HDRIs, etc., we can press this plus icon to add a new catalog. Double-click and name it something appropriate. Then go back to either all or unassigned. Unassigned will display, you guessed it, any assets that are not assigned to a catalog. Select the assets you want to move into this catalog and just drag them onto it. As far as I can tell, you can make as many catalogs as you want. You can also make catalogs within catalogs. And some bonus info, higher level catalogs will display everything in all of their subcatalogs. That's why they're really more like filters than they are folders, but I digress. Again, always save the file. Catalogs won't keep unless you save it. Now let's see how this will work when we go to use our library. Let's open a brand new Blender file. Let's pull up this workspace here and change it to the asset browser editor. Uh-oh, there's nothing there. That's because by default, it displays the current file, which is this file, and there are no assets in this file. Change this to our HDR library, and there we go. Our worlds are here. If you want to make the display images larger, click this button, and we can change the size of the preview images. Is the suspense getting to you yet? How do we import a world into our scene? Drum roll, please. Oh, let's go to render preview mode. Okay, here we go. Just click our HDRI and drag it into our scene. That simple. Don't like that one? Click another one and drag it into the scene to change it. This is a library you can continue to build over time as you accumulate more HDRIs. Just always add them into the one HDRI library file that we were working in. When we're in that file, we can remove a world from the asset browser by selecting it in the World Properties panel, and then right-clicking and choosing Clear Asset. This and any other changes that we want to make to the library has to be done in that original blend file. We can't move assets into other catalogs, rename them, or really do anything unless we are in the file where we mark them as assets. If you want to learn more about the asset browser and its other uses, I've created a current and comprehensive user guide, which is free, and it can be found with the link in the description or by going to brandonsdrawings.com/asset browser. Give me a like and hit that subscribe button if this was helpful. Stay creative.